I ran out of time in class today. I just wanted to help you with a couple more techniques. We actually did example number 7 last class, but I want to go over it again one more time. This is the original identity, and you want to turn all of this into a 1. And say, I don't know where to begin, so you'll have students trying to do like tangent over secant or trying to simplify. The thing that comes to mind is these are all different. Like you got tangent, you got secant, you have cosecant, you have cotangent. So in this case, your technique is to literally change everything in terms of sine and cosine. So you see that they wrote tangent as sine over cosine, cotangent as cosine over sine, secant is 1 over cosine, cosecant is 1 over sine. Anytime that you have addition or subtraction, think fraction plus a fraction or fraction minus a fraction. Get yourself a common denominator. So the common denominator is a factor of cosine times a factor of sine. So the factor of sine in the numerator gets multiplied by sine and you get sine squared theta. Cosine gets multiplied by cosine, you get cosine squared theta. Multiply the two fractions, you multiply across the top, you multiply across the bottom, you get 1 over cosine times sine. Now think, I have a big fraction and I'm dividing it by another fraction. So I take that first fraction, excuse me, even before that, sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is one of our Pythagorean identities, right? It's the main one. We got the sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta is equal to 1. So they replaced that statement, sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta, they replaced it with a 1. So they have 1 over cosine of theta times sine of theta multiplied by the reciprocal. And then what would happen is your factor of cosine cancels out and your factors of sine cancel out because this is all multiplication. And you end up with 1 over 1, and then you can say 1 is equal to 1. I verified the identity. The next technique that there'll be on some of the problems that I didn't get a chance to talk to you about in class is this identity right here. And I'm going to use my piece of paper to help you out. I think it'll make more sense if you see it, me doing it on the paper. So here's the identity. 1 minus sine of theta over cosine equals cosine over 1 plus sine. Okay. There doesn't seem like much you can do with this. You say, I can't replace sine, cosine. I could write sine as 1 over cosecant, or I could write this as 1 over secant, but it doesn't seem to be what I want to do. The original, either side, is already in terms of what's on the right side. The only difference is that cosine seems to have switched places, and instead of 1 minus sine, it says 1 plus sine of theta. This is another common technique with identities. On this one, it wouldn't matter if you did the left side or the right side, but here's what you're noticing. You're noticing that the statement is basically the same, except there's one of them says 1 minus something, and the other one says 1 plus the same thing. So this technique is called multiplying by the conjugate, C-O-N-J-U-G-A-T-E. So what we're going to do is I'm going to take the 1 minus sine of theta over cosine of theta, and I'm going to multiply the numerator and denominator by 1 plus sine of theta. And I'm going to multiply this by 1 plus sine of theta. You say, what gives you the right to multiply the numerator and denominator by 1 plus sine of theta? Well, all of this together is 1. So I'm not changing anything. I'm just basically taking what was already there and multiplying it by 1. You say, but how would I know to do that? What would make me say, oh, you should take the numerator and denominator times 1 plus sine of theta? Well, because you see that there's a 1 plus sine of theta in the finished product, and now we have 1 there. You say, but that took you far away from what you want up in the numerator. Now you have this in the numerator, and that doesn't look remotely close to cosine. but it will. Because when you take 1 plus sine of theta times 1 minus sine of theta, when you take 1 times 1, 1 times negative sine of theta, positive sine of theta times 1, positive sine of theta times negative sine of theta, the middle terms cancel out. Right? It's like saying, what is 1 plus 2x multiplied by 1 minus 2x? You say, well, it'd be 1 minus 2x plus 2x minus 4x squared. It'd be 1 minus 4x squared. We're doing the same thing on 1 plus sine times 1 minus sine. The result of that multiplication is 1 minus sine squared theta. The middle term canceled out. What do I have in the denominator? I have a factor of 1 plus sine of theta, and I have a factor of cosine of theta. So students will say, should I go ahead and multiply these together? Should I use the distributive property and write 1 times cosine plus sine times cosine? You could, but look at your finished product. It makes no sense to distribute this right now, because what you want to get to is sitting right there. So your thought process is, more than likely this cosine of theta is going to get canceled out, and I'll just have 1 plus sine of theta in the denominator. You look at this numerator, you say, I'm still nowhere close to cosine of theta. Yes, you are close to cosine of theta. Anytime you see like sine squared, cosine squared, secant squared, be thinking Pythagorean identities. And that very first Pythagorean identity, sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta equals 1, there's going to be a lot of times in these identities where you're going to have 1 minus sine squared theta, or you're going to have 1 minus cosine squared theta. If I subtract sine squared theta from both sides of this statement, I have cosine squared theta is equal to 1 minus sine squared theta. So I can replace this with cosine squared theta. Cosine squared theta over 1 plus sine of theta multiplied by cosine of theta. Now I think a lot of students, they'll go, oh, I can cancel out this cosine of theta and cancel out the 2, but they don't really understand why, I think. Make sure we understand that cosine squared theta means that you have 2 factors of cosine of theta. Right? Cosine squared theta means you have 2 factors of cosine. So when you cancel this out, when you say 1 factor of cosine is canceling out with 1 factor of cosine, that's why cosine squared theta is just becoming cosine of theta. Because the 2 factors are, one of the 2 is canceling out within the denominator, leaving you with 1 factor of cosine. And now in the numerator, all we have is cosine of theta, and in the denominator we have 1 plus sine of theta, and we have verified the identity. We verified the identity. This technique is called multiplying by the conjugate. How do I know when to use it? When I get to a position in an identity where I notice that my numerator is very similar to the denominator, the only difference is one minus something and the other one says one plus the same thing. So you often will multiply both the numerator and denominator by the conjugate, so that you'll get what you're trying to get to in the denominator, and then 1 plus sine times 1 minus sine, or 1 plus cosine times 1 minus cosine, that'll get you 1 minus sine squared, or 1 minus cosine squared theta, and you can replace it from the Pythagorean identities. They might also do that for the other Pythagorean identities, to say, if you multiply by the conjugate, you might end up with one minus cosecant squared theta, and that's negative cotangent squared theta. It's most often with sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta equals 1. The last thing I'd say is, Remember, with 1 minus sine squared theta, one of the options is to replace it with cosine squared theta. But there's another option. Another option with 1 minus sine squared theta is to factor it. Okay? And if you factor it, you go right back to where we were. So sometimes, instead of I was here, and I'm going to write it as 1 minus sine squared theta, sometimes you start out here, and you go backwards, and you say, oh, it's going to help me if I write 1 minus sine squared theta as 1 plus sine of theta multiplied by 1 minus sine of theta, because maybe there was a 1 minus sine of theta in your denominator already, and now you say, hey, those cancel out. So you have to think about different techniques and why you're doing them. And it basically is always dependent on what are you trying to get to? What's the finished product look like? So students will say, well, I replaced 1 minus sine squared theta with cosine squared theta. I say, yes, you can do that. But did you notice that in the final product, it just said 1 plus sine of theta? So it would have been better to factor it so that these would cancel out and you'd just be left with 1 plus sine of theta. Try the problems I ask you to work on. I give you the instructor solutions on Moodle. Take some ownership in your learning. If you cannot understand or figure out or you don't feel confident, come on in and we'll take a look at it and try to help you out.